Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see how to make and compose beats with FL Studio 12. Leave us comments to improve our next guides. Any project you make is composed by different patterns that you can check from the channel rack. Generally, each pattern is dedicated to just one kind of sound. For example, some patterns for melodies, some others for speech, others for creating beats. So also the beat patterns must be on their own. They should keep just beat channels active, no bass or vocals. Making a beat means creating a sequence of percussions and drums in order to define the basic rhythm and background of your track. Of course, there isn't a fixed rule to create beats at all. Those can change depending on the music genre you take and can even vary on the same genre. We will see some tips that are quite useful to help you making beats. A beat pattern is basically composed by some kinds of channels, like kicks, snares, hi-hats, cymbals, or claps, referring to the different drums inside a drum kit. A kick is a strong and short beat, quite useful to fix the rhythm of the track. Hats or hi-hats are much more delicate and are usually used to hit besides the kicks. Snares are very strong and short beats that catch the listener even more than kicks. Cymbals are like hats, but much longer, used to finish a cycle or elong a step. Claps are beats similar to a hand clap. You have two main ways to create a basic beat pattern. Create them manually or using ready-made beat loops. You can create your own personalized beats using the channel rack with its default channels inside, or with other drum instruments from the browser panel, going to packs and then to drums or legacy. Click on one to hear it, and click and drag it on your pattern to import it. Once defining the beat channels you need, play the pattern in loop and turn on and off steps until the beat is okay. The best way is to hear the pattern on and on while you change it. This is the most professional way. If you are starting as a beginner, you can start with ready-made beat channels. You can find some in the browser window, in loops inside packs. Each of these do cover one full bar in time, and they will be adapted to your project tempo once imported in the pattern. You can also download free beat loops from the internet, importing them as new channels by dragging them. Whenever you use ready-made beat loops, make sure to activate just one or maximum two steps per bar, or you will overlap everything. If you need to change the beat during your track, simply create different independent beat patterns. In this way, it will be sufficient to switch the pattern to paste inside the playlist to change the beat anytime. Let's see some more advanced techniques to render your beat patterns unique. In the top right corner of the channel rack, you have the swing bar, used to play the pattern steps differently. The more is the swing value, the less regular the steps will be played. Observe how the progress bar at the bottom changes. You can also edit your beats more into deep. In the top right corner, you can interact your channel rack with the piano roll window in order to make fast and advanced editing on each step of your channels. When you click on the button, the channels will be shown with triangles turned on and off. The green ones are steps on, where the beat channel hits, while the gray triangles are turned off and inactive, just representing steps that were previously active. If you click on a channel, you will open it on another window called Piano Roll that shows you each step active through green small rectangles and points at the bottom. On top, next to the channel name, you can choose to edit the pan, the velocity, the strength of the low pass filter applied, or any sound pitch. Then, while playing the pattern, simply pull up or down the point on each step active. In this way, you will edit the property that is defined on top for such step. When you finish, simply close the window. Through the piano roll, you can also edit the notes on each step. A higher note increases the high frequency components of the beat. A lower note increases the lower frequencies. The different notes are represented on the channel rack as well. Higher notes are higher triangles in the series. Mind that these techniques seen in the piano roll may not work in long loops. If you want to know more about the piano roll, watch the related video in this guide. Thanks for watching this video. Visit our full guide to know all the features inside FL Studio 12.